Hey, how you doing on Tuesday? This is James coming at you. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can make money trading and some of my secrets. So let's get straight into it. Now, it's now the 23rd of July, so markets are quite quiet. Let's go through a few things. If we look at crude oil, you can see it's up 4 points. Dollar basket is up 30. That's actually moving today. Euro is down, but the markets are pretty quiet. It's just stuck in the same sort of range. This is why the summer months, July and August particularly, are very quiet. But nevertheless, let's teach you something here. So let's go and have a look at gold. This is my real favorite investment right now, gold. Now, if we look at a weekly chart here, this is undeniably an uptrend here. So these are weekly bars. Weekly charts are more easy to predict. The shorter the time frame you look at, the harder you make it for yourself. When you look at it over a few weeks, things are far more easy to predict and you're going to be right a lot easier. You can see here that we've got a very nice uptrend in gold when we broke 1366. We really broke out, really, from 1366. That was the point. But we've been going up from this bowl or cup and saucer or whatever the hell you want to call the pattern. We've been going up from here. You can see we've got a beautiful uptrend here. And it's going up very, very nicely. Just looks like we're building some support at this 1400 area, then we're going to kick off another $100, $200 higher, I would guess, from my analysis of the situation. So first tip here, look at longer time frames. This is the first thing to succeed, is the shorter the time frame, the harder you make it for yourself. Longer the time frame, the easier you're going to predict, the easier you're going to be right on whatever it is. So think about this. This is really important, the time frame, because it's far more easy to predict what's going on. Let's go and look at something else now and show you something else. Okay, let's come out of the gold. And let's go to the Dow, what they call Wall Street. Let's have a look at this. This is 5 minutes now. You can see we're up about 100 points, but I'm not trading this until we see what's happening with the Fed. Yes, we are in an uptrend. We're at all-time highs, but everybody's waiting to know what the Federal Reserve is going to do. Now, so we can see we're all-time highs. Switch to the hourly chart. Now, if you see something on a weekly chart, you want to get the confirmation on a daily chart, then a four-hourly chart, then an hourly chart, and the more the time frames all give you the confirmation. If you've got the uptrend on the weekly, on the daily, on the hourly, on the this, that, on the all the time frames, if they all line up with one another, then this is another secret I've just given you, when time frames line up. Also, when you're looking at the Dow Jones, if you get NASDAQ, the Dow, and the S&P, all line up together, this is another secret to succeed. Also, you want to look at volume. You'll see down here, I got volume. When you get a spike in volume, this often confirms a trend change. Also here, I've got something called stochastics. This is when it's overbought up here. When it comes down to the bottom of the range, it's oversold. Often on the stochastics, you can predict the trend change. This is another secret, so I hope you're really picking up some nuggets of knowledge here. On the hourly, you can see where my line is right here. You can see it bounces off this support. One, two, three, one time, two times, three times. So you know if it comes down here to 27,000, it's going to bounce. You know why? Because it's a psychological round number, and human beings are like sheep, a lot of them, and they gravitate to psychologically big numbers, like 27,000 on the Dow. So you can see one, two, three times. So if it comes down again, there's a good probability we'll bounce again, or maybe we'll go through it. But just another little point there. You can see on the hourly where one, two, three, and once again. And what happened the third time? Bounced again, and then we go back up again. So just I hope you're picking up and giving away some real nuggets here of advice. So let's close this down. What else have we got here? Dollar yen, let's look at dollar yen. 108.20. We're stuck in this range again from 108, you know, 108.5 really, down to 107. And they can't decide what it's going to do. The dollar's going to kick on higher. Maybe we'll get a confirmation. But I don't like these, you know, sideways ranges. I like a really good trend that I can follow, really. Unless I can sell at the top and buy it at the bottom. If you can sell it at the top of the range and buy it at the bottom, then you can trade the range top to bottom. Remember, always buy low, sell high. And my number one saying for success in the market is money is only transferred from the impatient to the patient. You want to write that down, because money is only transferred from the impatient people to the patient. In the market, in property, in everything you do. And if you're a patient, listen to me. If you're a patient, the market always pulls back and it always gives you opportunity to make money. So I've covered a few things. I think that's enough for today. Quite a few golden nuggets there. I hope you listen to my advice. Write those down. This is really, really going to help your trading. And I'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe. Smash that like if you found value in this video. Smash the like. Hit subscribe, please. And tick that bell notification. Make sure you see all the videos. Comment on them and help me grow the channel. Thank you so much. I will speak to you later. Bye for now.